To fix ideas, here is a slightly better drawn picture of what I showed earlier. So here is the infinite series of rectangular pulses, and they extend in time in both directions. And here is a pulse going from minus tau over 2 to tau over 2. Sorry, minus tau over 2 to tau over 2, and the period is t naught, which goes from here to here is t naught. And the corresponding Fourier series consists of a set of coefficients CK, and CK is given by C0, which is over here, C1 is here, C2 is here, C3 is here, and so on. And then we correspondingly have C minus 1, C minus 2, C minus 3. It's symmetric. And this function that's shown over here actually is X omega. And what's drawn on this axis is actually omega. So we are notice that here we have X as a function of time. So this is time on this axis, and the coefficients of the Fourier series can be viewed as the values assumed by a function of omega, which is given by omega is 2 pi over t naught, which is the base frequency. So, and then what I said earlier was for the sine x by x function, as x increases along this axis, the amplitudes diminish. As you can see, the amplitudes get lower and lower over time. And so what's going to happen is that after a certain number of coefficients, there'll be almost no information added from these lower amplitudes. And that will become important going forward.